Shalom, Rabbi Boris and KJMC elders. It's a joy to be with you from Northern Mozambique and just share a little bit about what the Lord's put on my heart for you at this challenging time. I know that many of you have been dealing with so much with COVID-19. Also, there's been unrest in your country, but the Lord is faithful through every trial to take us through. I'd like to read from Romans 8 and starting with verse 35. Who could ever separate us from the endless love of God's anointed one? Absolutely no one. Absolutely no one, for nothing in the universe has the power to diminish his love towards us. Have you ever felt just a bit separated from the Lord? Have you ever felt like you were just disconnected in some way from the Lord? I know that there have been times, even in the last few days, that I felt disconnected. I felt this agitation in my soul rising up as people on the right and people on the left of our city, Pemba, Cabo Delgado, as people have lost their lives in this conflict that is just overwhelming to our spirits, as radical insurgents have come in to this province and from this province and causing so much damage, houses being burned, people dying. This is an extraordinary time. We're also dealing with great difficulty with our country being shut down in a state of emergency with COVID-19. So there's so much in our hearts right now. Our base has also been shut down. The very few children who are there, it's full quarantine for those few children there. And so we are in a time of great challenge and great stress and pandemic and wars and rumors of wars, and everything that can be coming against us is coming against us. In fact, even as we were trying to film this video for you all, the battery to the microphone was dead, even though it had been charging all night. The sun is going down, and then a truck drove by just at the wrong time, and everything, you know, just those little foxes that could just agitate you and even keep you from being able to do a message or being able to bring encouragement. But I want to say that we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. And so instead of just canceling this, and a few times I thought, we just can't do it. Everything is just coming against us. And people were coming over to the house, just telling us about more deaths. And our senior pastor, Pastor Pedro, his granddaughter is in the hospital, in a very shabby hospital right now, with cerebral malaria. So when you hear this, it's almost like, Lord, it's just too much. It's already too much. I can't deal with any more. I don't know if you, Rabbi Boris, and those that are watching ever feel overwhelmed like this, but I think since we're all part of this human race, that we all come to this place where we are challenged on every side, where darkness tries to come in like a flood. But it says the Lord himself will rise up and he will be a victory for us. And even when the storm is raging, Jesus, Yeshua himself, can say peace to that storm. So I want to just pray for peace to the storm right now in this world. Here we are. Could anything separate us from endless love of God? The answer is no one. The answer is no distraction, no war, no pandemic, no fighting, no death. Nothing could separate us from the love of Jesus. He is our everything. Nothing in the universe has power to diminish his love towards us. Troubles? Have you had any troubles? Today we've had enough troubles to last us for at least a year. Pressures? Does anyone feel pressure? Today I literally felt crushed by some of the pressures, and I had to just press in to the Lord. I had a fight with everything in me. Nadia prayed for me, thank God, before I did this recording, because sometimes you need, if there's only one other person there to pray for you, ask that person to pray for you, because the pressures of this day, just this day in Cabo Delgado, have been extraordinary. The things just this day that we have heard on every side have been extraordinary. But those pressures and those problems are unable to come between us and heaven's love. Hallelujah. Heaven's love. The love of God is faithful in all times. He is faithful. He is loving. He is kind. He is beautiful. Even if people on all sides are suffering, God's love is faithful for us. Another thing that happened today, one of my dearest, dearest spiritual sons, Shafin, who was supposed to be getting married to his beautiful bride in June, had to postpone his wedding for 3-4 months. They don't even know when they're going to be married. Why was that? Because of the fact with this COVID crisis, people can't travel. No one can come in and out of Mozambique. And it's just very painful for my dear brother. But I loved the way that he dealt with it. He just said, this too shall pass. This too shall pass, he said. And Shafin said, and the joy will come, the love will come. And he was just a great encouragement to me today as I listened to him, and he's busy. We've had to make a whole nother place to distribute all of the food and solar audio Bibles to all of our mercy mamas, to all the deficientes, those who are crippled and blind and lame, to all of these refugees, these displaced people. We're having to set up an entire another base, and Shafin is the main man doing that. And instead of him sinking into despair and just saying, woe is me, I should just give up, here I am ready to get married, and instead I'm trying to come up with this crazy plan to help people not starve to death, and he's staying joyful in the midst of it all. That is an amazing example of a believer. That is an amazing example of an overcomer in the Lord Christ Jesus. I am so blessed to know Shafin, and I feel like God wants to remind us through people like Shafin, through people that are victorious in the flood, that we too can stand victorious, that we too can walk in heaven's love. What about persecutions? What about deprivations? What about dangers and death threats? Well, let me tell you, beloved, right now we're very, very close to all these things. Our brothers, our sisters, their family, many of them, we don't even know where they are. I just got a text message before I started this message from a brother of mine who is in a village that just got attacked, and he is sending me messages from the bush saying that he doesn't even know where all the other believers are. We're talking in our province, we're talking in our situation, and right now we have brothers speaking, and you need to maybe yes, we're just asking them to kind of let us do this little video here. But I want you to know we have severe situations going on right now. Persecutions. People have been persecuted. Our families right now that we are arranging housing for, we're just overwhelmed with how we arrange enough houses. These are just for our senior leaders of our congregations, greatly persecuted. Their buildings have been burned. It's just unbelievable. Things that I can't even talk to about. These great persecutions that are going on right now in this moment. deprivations and dangers. Right now, thinking of these brothers that are trying to get from the places even a little bit further north. The last attacks are just literally less than an hour away from us, but people are still trying to flee into this little city. And so we are feeling surrounded, really surrounded. We aren't just feeling surrounded, we are surrounded. This is my time, my watch, my day with our team. And then we're feeling as these dangers are here, just crazy dangers where you don't know at night. I know I spoke to several of my friends and my colleagues, and most all of us said the same thing. They were unable to sleep last night. So why were they unable to sleep? Because the messages kept coming in about what was going on ao nosso redor, just around us. And so dangers are now, and death threats are now. These malfattors, these people who are coming in to destroy and to kill, they are not only threatening, but the way that people are dying is just absolutely horrific. So these situations are happening right now. But the Word of God says, no, for they are all impotent. Every danger, every sword, every persecution, every deprivation, no, they are impotent to hinder omnipotent love, even though it is written, all day long we face death threats. For your sake, God, we are considered to be nothing more than sheep to be slaughtered. Yet even in the midst of all these things, we triumph. Now, if I was just speaking to you from Laguna Beach, California, if I was just speaking to you from, but then Laguna Beach is in a lockdown right now, so maybe that's not a good example. If I was speaking to you in a cushy place that was just sensing no difficulty, no pain and suffering at the moment, it might be hard for you to relate to this message. But as I'm speaking to you in northern Mozambique, as I'm speaking to you in this situation that we are living in this month, April 2020, as I'm speaking to my beloved friends who are my beloved friends who are following Yeshua, who are loving Yeshua and fixing your eyes on Yeshua in the midst of your situations, in the midst of your difficulty, I know that you can hear that when I'm speaking these words, that there's an authority coming from heaven, because we have not fled the country. We have stayed our ground. We have stood our ground because we believe just being here in the midst of this situation is going to cause the atmosphere to shift as we worship with our brothers and we worship with our sisters and we worship with our families. Then things are going to be transformed. We are here, and the Word of God says that God has made us more than conquerors and has demonstrated love, love that is glorious, a victory over everything. So now I live with the confidence that there is nothing in the universe, nothing in the universe with the power to separate us from God's love. I am convinced that His love will triumph over death. Life's troubles, fallen angels, or dark rulers in the heavens. There is nothing, beloved. There is nothing, beloved lovers of Yeshua. Nothing in our present or our future circumstances that can weaken His love. God is omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient, and God is here with us. And I tell you, my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, even if I do not wake up tomorrow, in this, on this earth, I know that I have a heavenly home, that I am a lover of Yeshua, that he has saved me from my sins, that I am connected to the Father, that I'm filled with Holy Spirit, and the brothers and sisters all over this province that have come to know Yeshua, hundreds of thousands of people in this province over the last nearly two decades have come to know Yeshua as their Lord and Savior. Even if some of us do not wake up on this earth tomorrow, we know that we will wake up. We will wake up and we will be in heaven with our Lord. So there is no way that we can be separated from him. Even death cannot separate us from Yeshua. Even death cannot separate us. It's lost its sting. No matter what happens on this earth, God's love is faithful. His love is kind. His love is good. And we are citizens of another kingdom, the kingdom of heaven. And that is where we will live forever and ever and ever. So there's no power, no power above us or beneath us, no power that could ever be found in the universe that can distance us from God's passionate love, which is lavished upon us through our Lord Jesus Christ. And I think it's very beautiful that in the next verse, Paul's love, his love for the Jewish people, and I have great love for the Jewish people. And so I felt like even though today has been filled with so many challenges, that I wanted to send this encouraging message to my dear Jewish friends who are listening. Paul's love for the Jewish people. He says, "Oh, Israel, my Jewish family, I feel such great sorrow and heartache for you that never leaves me. God knows these deep feelings within me as I long for you to come to the faith in the Anointed One." So as I'm sharing this message, if there are any of you who have not yet received Yeshua as your Lord and Savior, I just wanted to pray with the Apostle Paul, the prayers that he prayed. He says his conscience will not, he says, "It will not let me speak anything but the truth. For my grief is so intense that I wish I could even be accursed, cut off from the Messiah, if it would mean that you, my people, would come to faith in him. You are Israelites, my fellow citizens and God's chosen people. To you belong God's glorious presence and covenants. The Torah, the temple, and its required sacrifices and the promises of God. We trace our beginnings back to the patriarchs, and through their bloodline is the genealogy of the Messiah, who is God over everything. May he be praised through endless ages. Amen." Amen and amen. I am just thankful, Jesus, just bring even more of our beautiful brothers and sisters into your kingdom. And I thank you, God, for so many. And I thank you, Lord, for these Jewish believers. And I thank you for their families coming home to you. And we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Yeshua, that you are going to protect them there in Ukraine, there in Europe, Lord. And we thank you, God. And we do pray that you would have mercy on us, Lord, that this COVID-19 virus would die out in Jesus' name. We pray for that, Lord. We pray for protection. We pray for a wall of fire round about all of us, Lord. All of those in Europe, Lord, in Eastern Europe, Western Europe, Lord, all about us here in Northern Mozambique, God. And we thank you for believers who will rise up together and love one another and trust one another and move together in the name of Yeshua. And finally, I just want to thank you, all of you who participated when we had that crazy cyclone last year. And I came to Ukraine, and it was because I have such a deep love for the Jewish family of God, such a deep love. I came anyway, and you blessed us, and we were able to feed such a huge number of people, many of them who were outside of the faith, many of them who received audio New Testaments, audio Bibles, and now because of your love and kindness and just gratitude and just beauty, they've been able to get the Word of God. And many, many of them who are in super crazy situations right now are able to hear the Word of God because of your love and generosity. So thank you for that. And we bless you. We bless you in the name of Yeshua. Shalom, shalom from Northern Mozambique.